Hey guys, this is Mr. V and this is APES review video, topic 5.7, meat production methods. Okay, so looking at meat production, there's a large amount of protein that can be cultivated and used for consumption. This is going to lead to humans finding different ways to grow their meat, right? And to make meat production. And so, spoiler alert, it's not that great. One of the main methods that we use is something called concentrated animal feeding operations, shortened as CAFOs or as feedlots. And another method that we're going to be looking at is free-range grazing, and kind of the consequences of both and the upsides and downsides of both. So this is an example of a CAFO. Now, one of the things I want you to notice is that the animals are stuck in very small pens. They don't have a lot of space and they're meant to be fed instead of having to graze and things like that. So that's going to be something that's going to come up as an issue. It might be asked of you on the AP exam when it comes to the upsides and downsides of this. So we'll be looking at that in just a moment. Whereas free-range grazing, so here we have some chickens who are allowed to graze for bugs, seeds, whatever it is they're looking for to eat. And so that's something that you can tell there's a difference in the way that they eat, and that's going to lead to a difference in quality of their lives as well as the quality of meat you get. So the first thing to make a point of is that meat is a very inefficient way of gathering energy. Okay, the number one reason for that is because it takes about 20 times more land to make the equal amount of calories than plants, right? Think about our trophic pyramids, right? When you think about that trophic pyramid, you've got to remember that if you're eating something at the top that is a large animal, contains a lot of meat, it's going to use all this land and food 10 times more than it takes for it to grow. And so that ends up being a big waste of space. If we could have used that plant material better and use that to draw our calories, we'd have a lot more space and a lot more ability to draw those calories. So now, of course, if you are going to eat meat and you want to use CAFOs, then you're going to get some pros out of that. The first one is it's going to produce meat very quickly. With the advent of antibiotics used in meat, with the space conserving methods of confining them, you're going to get it really quick, and it's going to be less expensive than if you did free grazing. Right now, the cons, the downsides of this is that obviously you're going to have overcrowded space. The animals are going to be fed grains that they're not used to when they're meant to eat grasses, right? And this has led to issues like the addition of E. coli 0157H7, which is a bacteria that's found in meat and has been known to taint meat and gotten people sick in the past. And of course, there's a large amount of waste that these animals tend to live in, and that can also end up in the food once it's slaughtered and cut up. So it's very inefficient, and there are many downsides to it. Now, whereas you have free grazing, you might say, okay, well, there's a lot of pros to it. That's true. Number one is you're not going to be using any antibiotics, which is a benefit. You're also going to have waste be the fertilizer. So they are going to be, the fact that they're grazing around, that's going to allow them to be able to fertilize the grassy areas as they are walking around. So it's a very easy cycle. And of course, it's going to reduce your carbon dioxide and your nitrous oxides, your NOx chemicals, which can end up in the atmosphere. So those are benefits. But the downside is you have to be willing to commit quite a bit of land. So remember, as we mentioned, meat is very inefficient. So even though you've changed to free grazing and that's a benefit, it's still going to end up causing a lot of land use. And of course, that can lead to overgrazing, and the meat itself, once you purchase it, is expensive. And the downside is too, a lot of people will travel to get organic foods or organic meats, and that ends up, using more fossil fuels. So it's not exactly a perfect system. Okay, and so one of the impacts we're talking about is overgrazing. So as you can see here, sometimes cattle, as much as we would like the idea of free grazing to be a good plan, sometimes if they're left in a certain spot too long, they may overgraze, and that could lead to loss of vegetation, which means the roots are not going to be there to hold down the soils anymore. So that means when it rains or if there's, irrigation for certain crops or areas nearby, that's going to lead to runoff into rivers and systems. And then in the long term, if you overgraze too many areas, that can lead to a problem called desertification, right? Not desert like, ooh, we love it, but forming deserts where there were no deserts before. Okay. So here's an example. So this shows the change in aridity. And as you can see, the red spots, they have been having spaces that, because of overgrazing, because of deforestation as well, that's leading to the spread of deserts. So you have places where deserts normally are, right? But now they're spreading and those edges are moving further and further. And so some continents use a lot more grazing, or they cut down a lot more forests, and the aridity is changing in those. So that's going to be a big problem in the future. So here's some sources to kind of help you gather more information about that. And hope that was helpful. Thank you.